Oshanla, Maferefunde, purest of the pure, the oldest of the old. She is fragile and wise, easily chilled and full of mystery. She hunches over from old age and walks very slowly. She comes to us from the land of Owu, I am told. Her vest must be white, and she likes to be kept with perfume and soft-smelling aromas around her. Her audaces are covered with cotton. A large white spindle shell is placed on top of her fundamento, and this represents her ear, with which she listens to all prayers. All of her tools are placed around the shells, and a layer of cotton is used to cover it all up. Her aleke is made white with ivory and mother of pearl. Silver coins can be added to her fundamento also. When she is birthed, she eats in a very peculiar way, as blood should not touch her otases directly. This orisha is seen as very old funfun, or a very old manifestation of Obatala. Those who have her received all tend to allow the orisha to rest and not bother her too often. She brings immense peace to the people who receive her, and right after her consecration ceremony, the person tends to go through a period of seclusion and self-search. Oshanla is fed all white animals only. Her sign is also made with special ingredients that change the color of her miedo. This orisha is said to live in seclusion and spends her day rocking on her rocking chair as she knits and entertains herself. She is often covered with some form of cloth in representation of a shawl. Do not be confused by her old age or fragile looks. Oshanla will get anything done faster than one anticipates, and will be meticulous as she can be. In the case of orishas, the older and more fragile they look, the more one has to respect their ache and how they are worked and called. With this orisha, one must always be dressed in white and must smell good. Make sure to be dressed appropriately when approaching her. She can be similar energy to Yewa. In front of her, one cannot speak loudly or say lewd jokes. Oshanla is a manifestation of the white cold breath. Her adimus should be all made with boiled eggs, ori, and efun. They should always be covered with a sheet of cotton. When this orisha is fed four legs, she is fed a female goat. Her ita must be done over a white sheet covered in efun and ori. She should be presented lily flowers as adimu also. If someone has this orisha as their alakbatori, when she mounts, she will shake from cold and needs to be covered with a white cloth to keep her warm. The person mounted will normally turn cold to the touch. Maferefum. Ache. Ache Oshanla. Beautiful, beautiful, amazing Osha that many of you may have heard of. Oshanla is an orisha of old age, and it is considered a orisha independent. And look me. Oshanla is considered an independent orisha from Obatala. Although there is definitely controversial opinions in that topic also, but in Lukumi we tend to see Oshanla as a female aspect, as a female Funfun Osha who lives all by herself and tends to her own needs. Also an Osha of immense peace, and her particular quality is that she rocks herself in the rocking chair and knits. That is her particular quality of entertainment and her particular ache. This Osha, Oshanla, is received for inner peace and inner tranquility of the individual. Most Oshas that have her received tend to not bother her too often, and we tend to also not birth her too often. Oshanla is an Obatala, is an orisha funfun that is just highly, highly respected within the Lukumi pantheon. I hope you guys have learned a little bit about Oshanla in this quick little video. Remember guys to get my book, Expansion of the Bodum, Orisha in the Diaspora by asieloshunyeyeo, yours truly. Make sure that you get your book. Oshanla is on page 186 and you can read about her. I did not add the bosses to this orisha in this book, but for the second edition and whatnot, I probably will, okay? But yes, get my book, please. Yay. Ache, ache, ache to. Just a quick interception here too for this video of Oshanla, and that is this Orisha sitting here next to her, and this is Opa Oke, also known as Opa Loke. This is another Osha that I want to talk about in another video, but this is considered the guardian of Oshanla, the guardian of Oshanla. So just in case, so that you guys know also, and why he is sitting next to her, Opa Oke, guardian of Oshanla. I'm gonna do a video all on him also in another video. Bye guys! Thank you.